should Tua go back to Alabama for his senior season?
Man, only time he going back to Alabama is to make sure that U-Haul,
right.
Second floor up there, right there. That's where my dorm is. Get it all out. I'm never stepping foot on this field again. One, for whatever bad luck means, 3 surgeries in 2 years for free? Playing at the collegiate level when you have the highest collegiate passing efficiency rating in history? Have y'all seen this guy really throw? Like, we all have, but have we digested what that looks like? It lands between the numbers and it snuggles.
Every time.
Every
time.
Thank you, because you cover college football. It's every time. So for anyone out there saying he's going to drop in the draft, let me tell you something, Tua, from a former player, your money's in your second contract.
Yep.
You're going to go first round because they want the 5-year protection. And on top of that, if you go later in the first round, Lamar Jackson's sitting there like, hey, it worked out for me. I'm the MVP so far. You go to a better situation even if you go latter in the round. So, Tua, only tell the U-Haul to go back to Alabama. You? Take you to the NFL.
I think he just made all my points. He has no reason to go back to college football at this point. He is the most accurate quarterback right now coming out of college football, and he has the quickest release of any of the quarterbacks. That ball is not in his hands longer than 2 seconds maximum. And you know GMs, coaches, executives, they're licking the chops to get their hands on this young man because he is a special talent. On top of that, he's the leader of the Alabama football team, the great Alabama with Nick Saban. So you know he's coached well, right? Mm-hmm. And you know he's coachable. But I just don't see why he should go back to college football. And on top of that, like you just said, this could work out in his favor because he goes to a team that's not as bad. When you're the top pick, you go to the worst team.
Yeah.
Miami Dolphins, Cincinnati Bengals. If he goes later in the round, he's going to go to a team that's ready to win, or they're just one piece away from ready to win.
I don't disagree with any of the points, but I'm going to just take a different perspective, a different angle on it. He will have had time to rehab and be healthy going into workouts and interviews with the NFL. But
not before the draft, he won't.
Well,
this sounds like a 6-7 month recovery.
Well, yeah. Then this even further makes my point then. I don't think there's anything wrong with taking that extra year, which is a real year, taking that extra year to be able for yourself to mentally, emotionally prepare yourself to get back to playing at the level you played before you had this injury. I have no idea what type of impact this injury will have. It's very rare. I've heard of a hip being, you know, dislocated.
Bo Jackson. Jackson's the only one. Well,
his is different than Bo's, okay. But let's go ahead.
And I'll say this, and you may have experienced it to a very certain high degree because you guys won a national championship, but where I came from and where I played, I never relived the experience and felt the experience of what, and I know money plays a part, but I never really experienced the joy and the amazingness of what the environment was when I played in college football once I left. And listen,
aww.
I know a lot of people make it about money. I understand that.
They do first.
And I get that.
Not us.
But in some instances, I could see Tua looking at getting healthy, making sure his mind is healthy. Because a lot of times we look at you getting healthy as just your physical, but mentally having that opportunity in school, I think wouldn't be a bad idea.
Well, Tua's family is not wealthy by any stretch. So I think there is some financial pressure.
They haven't been wealthy all the way up to this point.
No, right. No question about it. No question about it. But I just think there's a little financial pressure. Only because you all have stated the other side so well, I'm going to play the other side as well and agree with LaVar to some degree about, look, man, Alabama is a very special football atmosphere in place. I'm concerned he's going to go into the draft and there could be the benefit of him falling down to a good organization.
Patriots.
But there could also be a bad team that's like, oh, my God, the Patriots or somebody good is going to get him and we're going to regret this. So let me go ahead and continue to take him high. And then so you go to a bad team. If you go to a good team, they're going to let you sit a year. There won't be any pressure to put you out on the field. You go to a bad team, a coach could be in trouble, pressure on the organization. We got to get him out there sooner rather than later. And to me, the upside to returning to Alabama is to, I would just like to once see Tua make it through a football season without getting hurt.
Wait, you next.
Okay, well, look, I was in San Diego when Eli Manning was supposed to be my teammate. And no, there is a play there. If we got it, if a bad team picks you, there is a play there. John Elway obviously comes to mind as well. That's one. Two, there's no upside on the field for him to go out there in terms of draft status, only for the psychological effects. Mentally, it feels better. I feel good. But
let me ask you this, though.
Okay.
You still think right now he's the top five pick right now?
Top five, coming off this injury.
Yeah.
Top five pick. He's not going to be probably top five. I think he drops.
So that's some.
Yeah, but that's still going to be more money for a team, for a family that maybe has no money. That's still going to be more than that, but it's not going to be what you thought, pie in the sky. But that's coming.
Yep.
You tell that team, there are some terms in picking me, or I will Eli Manning this. I need the red shirt. Two, if you don't agree to that, I need to go. And he has enough. Listen to this, 87 touchdowns, 11 picks in 24 games, and the most efficient passer ever. You're going back to play? There's no upside for you on that field.
I still think that there has to be a focus on, and I've lived this and have watched it with so many young players, talented, gifted players. After an injury that takes place, there is no rehab and mental repair.
Yeah.
It's not taking place. And if there is one place where it would exist, where he would have a true opportunity to rehab, get healthy, and continue to hone his skills and improve himself, it's going to be going back to Alabama.
For free?
He doesn't need to improve, though. This dude is already the top dog right now.
Improve in terms of his health and what that means moving
forward. You want to rehab for free? You don't know what that looks like.
You don't know what that looks like.
Rehab to free.
Listen, and I understand that, but I am coming from a perspective now, looking at it hindsight, retrospectively speaking. I honestly, if I could have gone back to school for my last year of school, I honestly would have gone back.
Over the number and two overall pick?
I could have gone number one in the draft. They were doing contracts the night before when I came out. I had the opportunity to take a deal to go number one in the draft, and I did not do that. And I'm saying one, two, three, or four. If retrospectively speaking, for me, if I could do it all over again, I would have taken my last year of school for certain.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Speak for Yourself or go watch a few segments from our other shows on FS1.